I see fruit. So hold them down because none of them are ripe. Our contestants shall move into the audience. Our contestants again are Yodi and McKenna, and Werefox and Buddy. I see more fruit being handed out. There will be a 3-minute countdown, and I will call the colors of fruit as we begin the countdown. And then in addition, I should point out, they have to collect the fruit, obviously, in the little nets which they have. So our contestants should proceed on to the floor for the audience. And we will start out with, I believe, the green fruit being ripe. So as we start the count, the green fruit may be held up. Are you ready? Green fruit are ripe, and you may begin. Now, why are you touching my laptop? We're giving him a weapon. That's the worst idea. They will be given weapons, and their goal is to shoot them not at me, but through the holes here. Or until you run out of ammunition. I don't honestly expect it to take fully 5 minutes for them to run out of ammunition. Both contestants may fire together. There are weapons of choice on stage. No contestant may hold more than one weapon at a time. But once you're ready, you may simply fire whatever is needed. So is everything in place? It does appear so. Are the contestants ready? Then you may begin. So far that would be zero hits. Oh, I see a hit. Ooh, some hits on that side, maybe. You have another weapon on stage. You may know that you may come to stage and get your other weapon. But you will. No, I still see bolts coming out. You know, it's a good thing that I'm not using these to actually hunt with. Seems like the, I don't know what you want to call it. The one that you knock out is more effective. Get a count from them. The missiles are being counted now. And I believe team 7 looks like they're out of ammunition as well. Was that 17? 17 on team 7 side. The count is being completed on team 8 side. 11 on team 8 side. That means that this is a sugar. Continue with our next round. Congratulations, this is a sugar.
7 wins.
Seven wins.
How many did 7 get?
7.
11. 7. 8 was 17 or 18.
No,
7 was. I want those numbers. So, when Cubone and Ravel from Team 4 come out, and Rakshas and Belushka from Team 2 come out, they will migrate down to the stage again, or down to the floor again, and each of them will take one of those strings in their hands and attempt to navigate these round tins from the bottom to the top without dropping a ball that's in them through the hole. So then, are our contestants ready? Are our judges ready? You may begin. This is going to be a nice, slow game if it's done carefully. Actually, easier than it looks. I did this beforehand. And it seemed like it would be very difficult, but it's actually surprisingly easy. And in fact, they're both making good progress. Now that's a interesting buff that one. Ooh, they picked the dangerous route on that one. Ooh, serious dangerous. I was right. Congratulations. You did that in 32 seconds. That's very impressive. I did not expect it to go that quickly. 32 seconds, Cubone and Ravel. We're going to continue this same game with our second set of contestants coming out. Grisius and Sherbert from Team 7, and Jody and McKenna from Team 6. Now again, as before, our defeated parties shall have a chance again to recover themselves in a second round with us. We have nobody on this side. I see team six there. We step down onto the different ground. The rules are exactly the same as before. They have 3 minutes to do as well as they can. So once they have the strings in hand, then you may begin. We had a record of 32 seconds in the previous. Let's see how they do compared to that. Ooh, they're going pretty quick through this one. They're 15 whole seconds into it now. Very good, very good. 34 seconds. Or 30 seconds into it now. Almost. Team six, from making it to the top first. So, we have victors in our first two games. And a game that I must admit, I was opposed to when I heard about it, because I thought it was going to be virtually impossible. Relatively simple game. We're going to bring out some baskets. These baskets contain balls. And they contain wires that are crisscrossed below the balls. Each must pull out a wire without dropping the balls down. Okay, I see the first wire removed from this side, and the first wire removed that side, we have no additional balls that have fallen. So we may begin to proceed on the second wire. I see a ball moving close to the point. Has the second wire come out? No, or has he just moved a bit? Third wire is out from cue ball and rebel. And slowly coming out from Rakshasa and Baloshka. They pulled out more wires. You've pulled out more wires than them, so we're letting them, making them catch up.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, the wire is out. We now may proceed to the next wire on each side. You may now proceed to the next wire on each side. Oh, I saw a ball fall on this side. I believe I saw a ball fall on the left side. He has to get this wire out, and if nothing falls, he's good. And he got the wire out. That's 10 wires. They can get the next wire out, they're good, and they have done so. So now, we have 11 wires and one ball that fell. So, Rakshas and Baloshka have taken the victory in the second game, which means we are back into a tiebreaker again. Since the two tied in the first game versus the second, we will continue this game until the next ball. So wait until I tell you to pull a wire out of both sides. You may pull the next wire. Okay, you may be, yeah, I see one from each, you may begin the next wire. Hold here for a moment, because you're ahead of them. Hold. Okay.
Wait.
Okay, both sides may begin again. It's not the place for fine line warriors to have to go, but it is the way.